shatters yet and finally arrived. Made up of six aluminium and polycarbonate cylinders, each one had to be first squeezed into the bottom of the tower.
Made for it.
Attached to a winch secured at the top. And then carefully hauled up before being fastened into place. Finally, the elevator's base unit was carefully carried in. In just 7 hours, Dick and Angel's 19th century chateau had received a 21st century upgrade. And Angel...
In you go.
...was its very first passenger.
Shut the door properly. Okay. Choose the floor. She's gone. Been a lot of lifts, but this is fun. Willy Wonka would have been happy with this.
That lift, albeit not the cheapest investment that we've ever done, I think it's been priceless to us.
The lift is not the only success story. So is Angel's Tower of Curiosity, which has grown in size and colour since we saw it 3 years ago.
The room, it's changing. Every year, well, they're adding something new to it. It's been a little bit more painted, things are sometimes coming out, they're falling off. Now, I remember finding this letter up in the photography suite, actually, this little envelope. Oh, Dick bought me that, it's a little matchbox holder, which I love. It's a bit, our lives are coming together. All of these little things found up in the attic in the early days. It was in a sort of a lady's travelling case. You know, I've got these memories. Dick's got these memories. We're building memories. You know, when we found all of the old gramophone records up stairs in the attic. Oh, you've done a cracking job of Arthur. Arthur just looks. Oh, he just looks like my little boy. And that's all. We found him in one of the outbuildings, Stigma. And it was a horse sword, like a horse fighting sword, because it was twisted on the side. And I did not know that trivia. It's part of the Baglioni's and the Strawbridges together. It's just gorgeous. And my very handsome husband, in a similar outfit to what we had for our wedding, and I bought him this back in the early days, actually. This slightly manky sparring. And me, well, what do you think? I'm looking quite good. I'm looking quite swell. My hair's perfect.
I've got a full head of hair.
You've got a full head of hair. Being at more slides is totally the way forward. I love it.
Owning a 19th century chateau inevitably means massive maintenance bills. And the most daunting of them all is the roof.
If you're looking at big challenges and scary things, the roof, any chateau is always there as a big problem.
In 2014, when Dick and Angel were still looking for their perfect home, they were already aware that a crumbling chateau roof was a one-way ticket to financial ruin.
That's what it was done in 1909.
So the roof was always one of the first things they checked.
If you look out the window, you'll see that the shape of the roof has some major issues.
This still means I'm not getting off of
my room. So, on their first visit to the Chateau de la Motte-Houssant, Dick headed straight upstairs.
The roof here, the part of it's very old.
Old roof is the ancient chateau. See, this is the origin of the roof.
Yeah.
The tower roof's something by Nick there. The guttering looks new, we like that.
There was a good sign when we got here. They'd actually fixed the guttering rather than just leaving it, because we looked at other chateaus in our town where the neglect builds up and builds up and builds up to the point where they're destroyed.
But in March 2017, the northwest of France was put on orange alert as a fierce storm headed in from the Atlantic. 2,000 homes lost power. And the chateau itself was blasted by 75 mile per hour winds.
Meet the PMD Queen Pro RQ, a smart facial cleansing device from Sonic Lipid Launch, featured in Rome Court. Made of ultra-hygienic silicone, the PMD Queen Pro RQ is antibacterial, odor-resistant, and waterproof. No replacement parts, no batteries, and you can even leave it. After cleansing, flip the brush and turn on Active Warm. Use heat therapy with your favorite serum and moisturizer to assist in overt absorption. Order your PMD Queen Pro RQ.
The next morning, Dick braced himself for the damage.
This is a slate to come off the roof. Losing one slate's not the end of the world. The big thing is, what does that say about the condition of the roof?
The roof of an average semi-detached house in Britain is 75 square metres. The chateau's is a whopping 340, which could add up to 4.5 times as many problems.
You should not be able to see the sky out of your roof. There's quite a serious problem. I need to get you some advice on this.
You've got to know where your limits are. Dick and I both feel that we could probably give everything a go, but there's certain areas of expertise where you just think, leave it to the people that have been doing it forever.
Something you have to acknowledge is best than the other.
That someone else was a local expat roofer called Ian.
What's your top end? Okay, yeah.
It's a bit awkward. It's a bit steep.
Dick might not have fitted through the hole, but as even more a body camera, he did get a live tour.
Careful the slates.
Yeah. You see the bird?
No.
Look over there by the step.
Scary mystery.
It's a red bird.
Oh, I see.
It's a lot of engineering to make it look like this.
Between the step and the tree.
Let's try to get that one. You see?
It's a little one. As Ian peels back the lead line, the extent of the damage was fully revealed.
Shh.
Okay.
Quiet.
Lanky, isn't it?
It's a bit old.
The top slugs under the leg are crushed. I've got new slugs, so put them on.
When this chateau was built in 1868, 14 skilled labourers were needed to nail down over 29,000 tiles. 150 years later, he was using the same tools and technique. to fix the skin.
He got a bug. Like a cricket. Or is it a leaf?
That's a leaf.
That's a cricket. Or some kind of bug.
Is it green? It's like blending in.
When you get a chance, will you measure those measles on those kitchen cabinets for me?
Blending in because it's leafy.
You've got a ballpark sort of quote that people talk about our roof, and you said 140,000 pounds. That's a lot of euros to be spending out of it, okay? Scaffolding probably costs us 34k. Washington, down in the summer with only scaffolding, I think people would mind.
I think scaffolding the whole thing would be an issue in a wedding season because, you know, you.
Outer season.
Outer season, but then outer season, you know, you haven't got the.
Don't lean on a window.
And actually, the weddings and events are what pay is our biggest revenue.
As major roof work can't be done over winter, and they didn't want any scaffolding during the wedding season, Dick was forced to come up with another solution.
I can see a roof. I think I've convinced myself I need another window up there. Because that whole face on the left-hand side of the chimney has got no access to it. You have to climb around and climb over. Putting a window in on that side means you've got access to every side of the chateau.
And if Ian had easy access, no scaffolding would be needed, already saving Dick £40,000. Now it was just a matter of finding the time.
Last wedding in September, we say, right, October, and I'm straight in from the last wedding in September and see if we can do a face of this roof per autumn. So 2019, 2020, 2021.
It might take 6 years, but it would mean the Shadow would get a new roof. And because their wedding business wouldn't be affected, Angel would be happy.
This works in brilliant.